On the night Mikey Garcia dared to be good, Errol Spence showed he may be great. I've talked a lot on this show about how the business of boxing has siloed certain promoters and therefore certain fighters with certain networks. As a result, as has been the case throughout much of boxing's history, the fights we get are not always the fights we want. We get them because they're the best or biggest fights that can readily be made. Only once there is such demand for a fight that it makes sense for competing promoters and networks to do business with one another do we get the fights we really want, the super fights. So while fans want lightweight Vasily Lomachenko to take on same-size-ish Mikey Garcia and welterweights Terence Crawford and Errol Spence to get it on, business interests resulted instead in Garcia moving up in weight to fight Spence. Now, these four fighters, Crawford, Lomachenko, Spence, and Garcia, are significant because they're four of the best pound-for-pound in boxing. And because it was the undefeated four-division belt holder Mikey moving up in weight as the underdog to take on rising superstar Spence, it was also Mikey who seemed to have the most to gain, pull off the upset, and who could possibly dispute his claim as best pound-for-pound? What do Crawford or Lomachenko have on their resumes that could compare to beating a much larger elite fighter in a fifth weight class? Spence, on the other hand, seemed to have much less to gain along those lines. The good big man is supposed to beat the good little man, and Spence didn't even knock him out or really come that close. And so some observers were unimpressed. But Spence used his physical advantages intelligently and beat Mikey up and shut him out. Spence had previously proven that he could handle the big moment and hostile crowd and rough patches that didn't exactly go his way when he went overseas to Sheffield, England and took the title by force from the very good Cal Brook. The virtuoso performance against Mikey, who was game and fought well, but was simply overmatched and around midway through the fight seemed convinced he couldn't win, showed that Spence not only has the physical gifts to overwhelm the speed and punching power, the mental toughness to navigate choppy waters, but the southpaw skills and discipline to match, excellent jabs, stingy defense. And I sit here today saying that Errol Spence staked his pound-for-pound claim a couple Saturdays ago. He moved himself from a top 10 kind of guy into the top five. He went, in my eyes at least, from an excellent big fight opponent against Terence Crawford, who was likely to lose to the pound-for-pound champ, to an even-money proposition who has created a legitimate dispute as to who deserves that pound-for-pound recognition. And he had this to say to Boxing Scene's Keith Idick about Crawford after the fight. It's just going to take everybody to cooperate. The most difficult fight to be made is the Terence Crawford fight. It's for Bob to talk to my management, Al Heyman, and they to come to an agreement. But, you know, the Manny Pacquiao-Floyd fight was made, so, you know, I think it'll happen. To which Crawford's promoter, Top Rank's Bob Arum, tweeted, Errol Spence said that he's ready to fight Terence Crawford. We are ready to do that next, once Bud is successful against Amir Khan on April 20th. It's what fight fans want. Al, should I call you, or will you call me? Crawford Spence looks to be now what Canelo Triple G was a couple years ago. Simply, the best fight that can be made in boxing, period. My pound-for-pound list at the moment. Terence Crawford still at the top, followed by Lomachenko. It's close up there. Canelo Alvarez at 3. I think Spence, as I said, is in the top 5. He's at 4. Alexander Usyk at 5. Great year out of him. Triple G at 6. Inoue at 7. Already won belts in multiple weight classes, a physical phenomenon. Soaring Visai at 8. Mikey Garcia at 9. Listen, he tried. He moved up. He's still an excellent fighter, even if he got shut out by a much larger guy. And heavyweight champ Anthony Joshua